Hey, what's up chickies? It's Baron here. Don't forget to check out our Discord, watch this video all the way through to the end, and we have a merch link down in the description. There's all sorts of stuff down there, so go check it out, all the discount links. We're going to talk about Pyro today and the possible ships that we could be seeing with release. Yes, this is my macaw Millie. She's really quite attached to me and it sometimes gets annoying. But we're going to be talking about the Odyssey. We're going to be talking about the ships that we could be seeing releasing with Pyro. Now, we know that the Merchantman has been pushed back. Yeah, the Merchantman. I know you guys love this stuff right now. So, the Merchantman, Pyro. The Merchantman has been pushed to quarter four, but we could possibly see it being brought back to quarter three in my eyes anyway, because Pyro is looking for like a a quarter three release. I don't know why it's not getting the first letter, it's so dumb. So we could be seeing a quarter three release, and then later on we could be seeing Pyro space stations coming later, which are little like rest stops and whatnot, as we do have in Stanton. So as you can see, the Pyro system and planet missions and everything is set to be done in quarter three at August. Yes, it could be pushed out. I'm going to keep my eyes and my mind sort of positive and saying, yeah, yes, we're going to get these. It's going to happen. So in my mind, I'm thinking, what sort of ships can we expect? So the Odyssey looks like it's coming out for a quarter two release, which is also really great for the people who own one. I might get one myself just so I have one when it gets released. I don't really need it, but it would be nice to get familiar with it, learn the ship and whatnot. So people are also been talking about the Liberator, but I don't think the Liberator is going to be coming anytime soon, as that hasn't even been worked on since its original concept. Yes, I know, but it could also be an unannounced ship. But again, they haven't been updating these roadmaps very often. I know that we got the SRV coming, so the tracked beam ship that's coming back in to quarter two, quarter three, looks like a quarter three release, maybe quarter four of 2022. So again, this could be releasing next to Pyro. See what I'm getting at here? They seemed like they might actually release Pyro with a bunch of ships. So it could be the Merchantman, could be the SRV, and it could be the Liberator and a bunch of other ships if they decide to bring those on. So we've also got the Genesis Starliner, which is probably being reconcepted as we speak in from quarter three to quarter four, in mid quarter four. So we could possibly be seeing something at CitizenCon on this ship, some sort of reconcept of it. We could be seeing a few reconcepts of some ships over there. But again, with Pyro becoming something of more of a fiction, we know that it could possibly be coming out sometime in quarter three. Yeah, I know everyone's like, oh yeah, it's not gonna come out, blah 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 blah. I don't care. This is my opinion, and if you don't like it, go down in the comments, let us know. But again, everything I say right now is based on how I feel about it, what I think. Now, we also got the Vulture coming in quarter two, which is also going to be really fantastic. Obviously, we're going to have the salvaging gameplay, which is also going to really mix in great with Pyro and just some of the things that we can do over there. It's just going to be something to experience, something that's going to be amazing. And I think that they may actually release the Merchantman alongside Pyro, because the actual fact that the Merchantman is so powerful and can jump such great distances, it's got so much going on in it, they could actually release it with Pyro at CitizenCon and just make a big deal out of it, obviously being one of the biggest ships, and they could then start a sale. Now, saying that, I don't know what the price is going to jump to. Obviously, it's jumped to $50 increments. We could see another $300-$400 added onto that ship. It's going to be, we could expect a $50 rise in every sale that we see. So IAE, Invictus, I would say we would probably see a $50-$75 at Invictus, maybe more. I'm not 100% sure, but I can definitely say that we could expect it to be coming out around that sort of time frame. So we're also expecting Hacking 2, a little bit of an improvement with the back end on that in quarter 3. We could be seeing a lot of stuff coming in. It's just people haven't really been looking at this. Yes, I know I sound crazy sometimes, but I don't really care, because what I can see is they're making some really good progress. The jump points, yes, quarter 4, but again, they could be just working on it over that to that fourth quarter, and they could just be releasing Pyro and having jump points ready to go quarter three, but then obviously still working on jump points, because it's something that will need to be worked on and it may need to be reiterated, as they do know and we know that. But again, there's a lot of stuff being worked on. with Pyro, I feel like there's going to be a massive event. So they could do something at the jump gates. They could do a lot of I don't know what you would want to call it, but they could do an event at the jump gate. There could be some sort of a battle. I'm thinking that there could be something to do with Xeno Threat being at the jump portals. It's just going to be such an amazing experience the way they're going to put it down to us. I feel like this is going to be a one time, like one event that will just change everything. We also got the 600i gold standard at the quarter 3 of 2022. So everyone who's looking forward to that, that will be pretty awesome. We've also got the Origin X1 at around quarter 3 as well. So you're seeing what I'm getting here with this. And people are going to say, oh, you know, there's a lot of speculation here. Yeah, if you don't like the speculation, go somewhere else. I don't want to hear it. I see comments on it all the time. The people who do want to see this and do want to listen to this, that's great. Thank you for stopping by. Thank you for staying. I hope you're enjoying all the content that I'm giving to you lately. So we got refinery ships here. So what's this? Certain ships will have refineries built into them, allowing players to process or using a completely onboard process. So this would be the ship that they're going to be bringing out as of now. And they could be doing this for something like the Starfarer, then the Odyssey. So that system could be implemented, ready to go, so that when the refinery ships do come out, bang, they can do that process and they have that functionality. So we don't have to be sitting around with useless ships just waiting for nothing. We've also got the RSI Apollo, which is being worked on as well. So with this ship coming into at quarter four, it could be even pushed back to quarter three. I think we can expect great things with this, because obviously we're going to need something like this over in Pyro. Me having one myself, it's going to be something that's going to be quite an event, and it's going to be quite a useful ship to have in fleets. So we've also got space mines. Yeah, I know. I would say that we could be expecting the Nautilus around this time as well, possibly. I mean, I'm not saying that we could be, but I'm saying that it could be a definite possibility of seeing this ship coming to the verse. But again, there's just so much stuff going on. There's so much content coming. People don't really understand how much is going into the game this year. Jared's moving to the UK. There's just a lot of stuff going on in content sort of terms. But again, I want to know what you think. Let me know down in the comments what you all think. And yeah, it's been a great day. If you guys have been playing some Warzone, some of that Rebirth map, hit me up in my Discord. I'm smashing that stuff right now. Battlefield War, World War 3, everything. Just let me know what you want to play, and I'll see you in the verse.